Looking at this example, the other two zeros of pz, the function z, if this is one zero. Now, only looking at this, this is of the third degree, this polynomial, which means there will be three zeros. Therefore, I can see that pz will have three zeros, and that means that z minus z1, z take away z2, and z take away z3 will be the three factors. Now, what the conjugate root theorem tells us is if all these coefficients that we have over here are real numbers, which they are, then all of these values are real, so all the zeros are real, or they come in conjugate pairs. Now, one of these roots, and let's call that let z1 equal 5 plus 5 square root 2i. Because this is already a complex number, it means that its conjugate pair must also be a root, which means z2 must be the conjugate of this, and the conjugate of that is 5, take 5 square root 2i. So we need to find z, so that's already the second one. So we only need the third zero now. And the third zero is going to be z3. So how are we going to get that? What I'm going to do is I'm going to say, okay, pz equals, and I'm going to substitute these values in there, which means it's going to give us z, take away z1, which is minus 5, negative 5 square root 2i. That is z2, which is z take away 5 plus 5 square root 2i, multiply by z minus z3. Now I can simplify this because that's the difference of two squares. Remember the conjugate, so it's the opposite of what we've done previously. This is the same as, if I use my, just to highlight that, those two are the same, which means that is z minus 5 squared minus this thing squared. And this thing squared is 5 times 5, 5 times 5 is 25. 25 square root 2 times square root 2 is 2, 25 times 2 is 50. I squared is negative 1, which makes this plus 50. And that needs to be multiplied by z minus z3. Now I'm going to multiply this out. I'm going to have z times z, z squared. Z squared minus 5z times minus 5z is negative 10z. Negative 5 times negative 5 is plus 25 plus 50 is plus 75 multiplied by z minus z cubed. Now, if I look at this and this, it means that if I multiply this out, I need to get that. The only way that I can come to this real value is what is 75 times z3? Because that's the only real numbers or the only constant values there. So what I can see is that z3, negative z3 times 75 must equal 150, which means that z3 equals divide by 75 divide by 75 is 2, and therefore divide by negative 1 equals negative 2. So z3 is negative 2. So what's the three zeros? Therefore, the two zeros that required is z2, 5 minus 5, 2i, and z3, which is negative 2.